Holy wire mod.
Holy wire mod here, and this is going to be tutorial 10b in the Lua series, where we're going to be continuing chat, except we're going to be going over commands. And I'm going to show you two different methods. The first is from the server side, and the other is from the client side. So, from the server side, if we were to do it, we put this hook, and we're going to use this method. And the hook that we're going to be calling is player say. Now remember, you can assign any kind of identifier, it doesn't have to be anything fancy, so you can put it whatever you want. And then we'll have a function which has the argument player, the player's text, and the player's team if you should so need it. So let's say that the player says something like hurts, like this, and we want to make that a command. So we can do that. By doing that, it'll check if the text is there. Now we'll say that player set health, that's the command, and then you say player health minus, let's say 100. And then after that, you can say return. And the return here is kind of cool though. I like it on the server side because you can set the text to say whatever you want when the player says exclamation point hurt. So we can either leave it like this and it will show no text, or we can say ouch and make it fun. So then let us do another quick text before this return and say that if player's health is less than or equal to 0, then you guessed it, player kill. Alright, and then it will return ouch. Okay, so let us go in the game and we'll see what that does. Alright, so we are now in game and I'm going to type our newly formed command hurt, and as you can see it says ouch in the console, and it also reduced my health. Let's do it again before I regenerate to 100. And I'm less than 0 HP, so it killed me. Alright, so that looks good. Now, there are also other commands you'll see typically on a role-playing server where you might say, out of character, you'll see this one. And then you can type some stuff and whatnot, but then it looks like that. So how do they do it? Well, what you could do is say, if the string, and we're going to get a sub right here, and we're going to be looking at the string text, which is the player's input text. And let us look at the first four characters. So we're going to start from the first character, end, and the fourth character here. And let's say that that text is equal to OOC, to say out of character. Then what you want to do is you want to return, and this is very simple, it's why I like the server-side version better. You can say OOC, just like that, and say string sub, so we're going to be using the same command. We're going to look at text, and instead of ending it, we're going to start it at the fifth character in the string that has been typed out. So it's usually going to be that space, and then you're going to type your message right here. But we're not going to have an ending point, and that will allow us to analyze the fifth character all the way to the last character of text, okay? Simple enough, so let's save that real quick. Now let us type OOC. Hey everybody. Alright, so as you see, now it puts hey everybody in parentheses, puts OOC out of character, so simple enough, right? So, I mean, you can do that on the server side, it's pretty awesome, I like that. Now let's look at the client side. You'll be like, this is a sweet hook, you might say. Okay, so here you're going to do the hook on player chat. And remember, you can have your unique identifier, doesn't matter what you call it. And we'll have function. And the arguments for this one will be player. You're going to have a string. You're going to have the team. Should call it something else than team because it lights up purple. Actually, same here. Same here, I did that here, so we'll call it B team or something. So, and then we'll say dead or something like that. I don't know if they have one for dead, but just in case, put be dead. And in the hook, don't forget that, or something bad might happen. So then you'll say, okay, so if the string is equal to, let's say, print. So I use a basic print command for this one. Nothing too fancy, nothing too hard. And remember to set the string's lowercase, so we don't have it case sensitive and you don't have a huge mess if someone uses uppercase. All right. And then we'll say print, hey everybody. Or that's another way of saying hello world. But this way is cooler. All right, so then this return is going to be different than the server-side return. When you're returning on the client, it's going to be a Boolean saying, should I suppress this message that was typed, or this string? And if you say true, you'll suppress it. So let's go in here, and I'll show you what it's like. So remember, it's slash print. That's our command. So go print, and see. It says, hey, everybody. Now, if we go and we put false here, it will not suppress it, and it will show the slash print when we type it. So as I type it, there's slash print, but as you can see, hey, everybody. All right. So that's going to be a very good starting point for chat commands. You can do so much more with them. If you have any questions, as usual, feel free to ask.